All right, you guys are recording. You're good to go.
You want to commentate?
Yeah, God, I want to watch this so bad.
One more commentator.
Not you.
Ace?
Yeah, Ace. All right. You all know the terminology better than me.
All right, guys, give it 20 seconds. Announce yourselves and go to it.
All right.
How you doing?
Good, Ace.
Excellent. Okay, are we starting?
Yes. All right, so this is your Fluffle Singles Finals, Grand Finals. This is Gigan Terra and
Ace Star.
And we've got KP Kiro against Katakiri. This will be best out of five. Starting off on Battlefield. Now, I've seen this match before.
Correct.
But our very first tournament, actually, way back in March. And I freaking loved it. I hadn't seen play at that level before in person. So I'm really excited to see this matchup again.
Yeah, these two have a kind of rivalry going on. They're always in the top places. Mm-hmm. And they always have to fight each other eventually.
So
it goes back and forth whoever wins usually.
I think our first tournament we didn't have any seeding. So this match was the first match of the entire tournament.
Right.
And then you got to see it come back at the end.
Who ended up winning?
Katakiri, I believe, ended up winning. It was 2-3,
right.
I believe.
Really close.
Was the final score? Very, very close. I actually think they reset. So, TO, you're like, ugh, but you want to see it go
right.
That way. In my opinion, I want good matches.
Now, this is really close right now.
Yes.
Unfortunately, Carol gets most of his kills from the top.
Yep.
And it's going to be really hard to use on a stage like Battlefield
because
of high shielding. Same thing with Meta Knight. So I guess the saving grace here is that Greninja's down throw was buffed. And so now he's able to get some kills from this high or possibly through his down throw to a 4-air. So
there,
if Carol can get that after a read, then he can definitely get the KO like now.
Yes.
And all Katakiri needs is like an up smash at this point.
Wouldn't he be able to take him out with a quick forward smash too, wouldn't
right.
he?
Correct.
And what frame does that come out on for Meta Knight? Because I know you can...
Afterwards, frame-wise.
For Meta Knight's forward smash.
It's 4-0? Well, I do believe like 3-18.
Okay, so it's...
The cooldown on it is like really low. Oh, nice in there.
Yes.
That actually was buffed. And it comes out frame 6. You think it would come out faster, but frame 6.
Still pretty quick.
A lot of knockbacks. The thing about Meta Knight is that every patch, or almost every patch so far, he's been buffed in some way. So the character doesn't seem like it's going to be nerfed anytime soon. So Katakiri get a good job chipping this character in the very beginning.
Yeah.
Because this character keeps on getting buffed and buffed and buffed.
It's nice to see improvements.
It's actually pretty even right now.
Huh?
It's actually super even right now. Considering it's like 2 minutes, 3 minutes? Almost 3 minutes.
It's almost 3 minutes, 8 minute match. I think they're both trying to be a little patient.
Right.
And see how each the other one's going to approach.
They both have really good neutral games.
Yeah.
Nice.
Nice indeed.
Later up smash. Lots of damage.
Yep.
Now, in the beginning, Katakiri was doing this, but now it looks like Kiro is taking the lead. We'll almost have that read.
Almost. In there.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Now the thing about Meta Knight is if you don't kill him quickly, you're gonna have to deal with his up air to up B strings.
Yes.
That kills super early with the rage.
It does.
So
it does.
So
you wanna take him out, and when you get that percentage up there, you kinda put him at the advantage.
Correct.
And that that combo just feeds straight into each other so well.
Correct. Like, you see how much knockback that does? Like,
yeah.
I mean, it should be a punish. Good job. So, Carol's in the lead now.
I think you should get that one.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. All right, half the match is literally almost gone.
Right.
Get in there.
But it's not like they're camping either. They're just feeling each other out. So
yes,
often.
Yeah. Well, potentially, for Kiro, this could be a very long set. If
correct.
He resets it, he has to do another set of five after
correct.
This. So,
we all know who he played, how he played.
Yeah.
But we love him.
He can weather the stress of doing that many matches, but...
Right.
I don't know if he technically wants to. I figured he'd like to take it. Well, he has no choice. He has to. Katakiri might just, I don't know if he'll use the strategy, but, you know, fight and really stress him out in the first five and then try to wear him down for the remaining.
Katakiri likes to really bait. That's one of the things that he's super strong at. Wow, lots of damage from Carol, actually. Yes. Whoa, look at this conversion.
I see it.
Carol could have actually gone for a forward air there, but he didn't want to go too far. Loads of damage. Wow.
Get in there.
100 difference lead right now.
Get in there.
He's trying to punish those shadow sneaks with the neutral beat, but each time he's like trying to get out of it with his shadow sneak. Watch out, watch out, watch out.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow. Good thing they had a high blast on there, because if not, Kira would have definitely been out.
In a bad spot. As you said, that high percentage.
Like, he has to take him out, like, well, to a certain enough percent, and you get a certain enough percent, he has issues killing because he can't string into you anymore.
Yeah, so you can't count far.
So right now, it's kind of, ooh, almost had that read, too. Oh, it's extremely close. Oh. Nice shot bouncing out of there. Nice shot spacing that LP too.
Yes, yes, yes. Right, and one thing that always impressed me is Kiro is patience.
God.
I don't know. I mean, like, I just look at this and I see just like how well he's thinking. I can just see in every move he's making what he needs to do next.
That was so close.
Yes.
Would have been dead just now.
Oh! Oh,
very close right now. He's almost in that range. One more will do it.
I'm gonna say, will that not kill? Oh my god.
One more up will probably do it. Uh-oh. Yeah, it's definitely gonna kill at this point. So Carol probably is gonna be fishing for that now.
Yes.
Oh, it's so close right now.
We're getting down the minute mark. Getting down the minute mark.
He tried to look for it too.
Oh no. Ah!
This is very close right
it
now.
Is.
Good thing. I hate how he didn't drop through the platform, because if so, he still wouldn't be able to wrap it. And it is out.
Waited, he almost
went for it. Oh, goodness. Oh no, that's so close.
Oh!
Yes, there it is. Very close.
And almost. Don't say. There we go.
Wow, that almost took 8 minutes.
Almost a full 8 minutes. These guys, they like to do the full 40 minutes. That's why. Yeah.
Wait, my God, I'm used to it.
Yeah, we will be here for quite a while.
7 minutes and 20 seconds. Potentially five more to go. All right.
Yeah, potentially. All right, here we go. Let's see if they're going to switch up. The one thing I want to see them do, I mean, I guess they could always agree to play the stage again. But the last time they played, they kept going to Omega every single time. And I think eventually Katakiri had the matchup ready on that stage. And they needed to switch, and they just did not. Yeah, I don't know if they were tired or they just wanted the set to end and just keep going to the same stage and play it out. But hopefully we see a lot of change-ups this time.
The thing about this stage is they both really benefit from it. What? Good battle. Yeah. I'm gonna do it. I wanna do it.
Yeah.
Do it. Right now? Okay,
good.
Well, A-Star had to leave because we're doing this stuff.
He's doing the crew battle.
Yeah.
And those should be recorded as well. Thank you, good sir, for your input.
Gosh, what happened? Okay. All right, thanks for having me.
Yeah, have a good match. All right, so now it's just me, Guy Gutierre here. My best accommodate. Usually I get pretty quiet when there's a high tense match going on just because that's all I'm thinking of. What are they going to do next? Wow. Kira was doing that last time against Joey, just be able to get that. I don't know what it's called, where the side B is, the illusions. He's able to get it in there. Oh, actually got him with that. I don't know technically the names of some of their moves. I don't know the names of their moves. So what is Greninja's side B called?
Shadow Sneak.
It's Shadow Sneak.
Okay.
And the counter is Substitute.
Correct.
Now what's Meta Knight's down B where he's able to do that teleport?
That's Dimensional Gauge. It has the catch ability until obviously he reappears.
Yes.
At this point, he's just looking for the a little bit more percent to go for the up throw. I think we're actually at that point. Yep, right now.
Yep. And I don't know.
That SP looks really bad.
Okay, so this stage has a lower ceiling. I'm assuming at this part.
Correct. No, at all parts.
All parts, yeah. Okay.
It benefits them both, but mostly Meta Knight because he has an easier time getting them.
Yeah, getting people up there.
Correct. Nice pivot grab. Wow.
That pivot grab is so pretty. Lumpy was doing it earlier.
Right.
Ah, God. It
looks really cool.
It does. It looks really cool and slightly annoying. You're playing against it. But with practice comes that, so.
Well, I'm sure he's playing a little bit odd. Oh, wow, that's pretty
cool. He hasn't played a match in a while. So he's been sitting here waiting for losers to finish out, so maybe he needs a little time to heat up. Get warm, whatever you want to call it. Warm up. That's the correct terminology.
Almost got that too. Oh, that's pretty fine. Here, I'll probably just wait on the platform and get all up. Wish. Nice. Oh, really? Oh, nice.
Yes.
Covered a lot of options there. JB3.
Oh!
Wow.
All right.
That's amazing.
Now, this would be
far less time.
Yes. Far less. What was that one? At least 3 minutes, maybe?
All right, so Kuro's one game away from resetting the bracket.
Yep.
It didn't take as long as I thought it would.
He looked really good in that match, definitely.
I'm not sure if Katakuri wants to go back to that stage.
I don't know if he wants to.
He probably wants Low Blast Zone, but I wouldn't do something that would also benefit my opponent.
Yeah. Well, where was that going to come into play if they both kill up in the air?
Right. Maybe they should just go to an even stage, like a Final Destiny.
Yeah.
Unless it's Vanity.
Something going down with the crew battles. I'm assuming he doesn't change his layout.
Who knows? I wonder why. Maybe because he wants to save time.
Maybe. He does normally, doesn't he? Most higher players do anyway. They've got something that's different that they're accustomed to and built into their game.
He plays with tap jump on. Amazing. I find people who play with tap jump like really astounding.
Well, I mean, melee you couldn't turn it off, right?
Right.
So if you were already used to it, just keep it off or keep it on. I know when I play melee, I have to have this. I'm like, yeah, if I do it once, I'm like, why? Why? Ever just built my game around not having an on. But I don't play the same characters in the other game, so it helps too.
They are actually getting to an Omega, though.
What?
They're getting to an Omega.
They're going to Omega?
I think I thought so. It's like, Katakuri doesn't want to go somewhere that would pick hero. But also, he hurt himself.
Yeah.
So this is probably the most even state for that. If you notice the smoke, Garrow tried to get out of it with Shadow Sneak.
Yes, he did. Now, that worked against him in the last tournament very well against Joey, but Joey ended up taking it in the end because Kiro SD. But I've noticed inputting that Shadow Sneak a lot more to get out of combos. You get just some percentage or punish a little bit on there. To me, it's impressive because I don't think most characters, not every character.
Oh, did you see that?
I don't know exactly what happened.
Meta Knight tried to go for Shuttle Loop, and Kiro predicted it and then canceled the first hit with Shadow Sneak and was able to punish him. Amazing. That's actually really cool. Because that would have... Look at that. You see it? Again.
Mm-hmm. He's getting that technique down. He's use that move.
Can't do it the third time.
Wow, that didn't kill.
One thing I have to say about Katakuri is that its edgeguarding ability is really nice.
That's the thing I noticed most about the first time I saw these two play. Was it was like... constant, off the stage, bottom corner fighting. Which I found very impressive.
Oh no.
Well, that was almost a minute and a half for the first stock. This one may be a long one. Man, he did it like three times. Shadow Snake.
Each time, Carol's getting kind of slow. He needs to stop doing it.
It kind of seems like he's counting on him to do it now.
Gotta carry a really big move. Nice down.
That percentage on him. Oh god. Wow. About 90 on that
opposite left.
Yes, almost. Letting him fall into him. Yeah, that control Katakiri has where he wants his character to go. He's using those jumps to his full advantage. Love it. Give it to him.
Amazing how back and forth this works.
Yes. Go, go. Get in there. I'm trying to go for that grab. I don't know if it'll take him out at this percentage.
I don't think it will.
I think he's going to have to be at least 130. There's that down throw you were talking about.
Yeah, he's trying to get somewhere to follow up. It's not working out.
Well, Mennonite being so quick, I think it's sort of risky to go out there for it. With just one stock left at a disadvantage.
Reckless dash attack, I see.
Oh! Off the stage.
Over there.
Yeah.
Wow, it's not completely out of Kuro's reach. He just has to be careful.
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh!
Good reaction speed.
Go for it.
Oh, he just grabbed it after it anymore.
Oh, it's very close.
He's punished. Oh, this still got some going off.
Oh, no punish. Get in there, get in there. Trying to build that percentage up.
Wow, he's slowly bringing this back. Like, if he gets a good read, like, it could be over. It's game three.
Yeah. Game three. Zero's two. Is that two, yeah.
Reset?
Yeah.
Oh! Wow, reset at the bracket. Nice. Amazing.
Got it. Reset.
That's a reset.
Reset.
Carol's not getting it. Carol's the champ, dude.
You want to go put that one in?
Froggy champ, yeah, put that in.
Putting Eddie. Alright, so we totally got a reset. Right. 140 minutes.
Sign off. Record that one. Stop recording and record again. Like verbally sign off.
Alright, so Gigantara signing off here.
Ace Star signing off.